Good afternoon. I am privileged to be here at a call of MECD, especially the President MECB, who called me to come over here and to deliberate upon you. And I thought that the roadmap for smart coastal village creation will be a very good topic to discuss with you and deliberate upon you, because the fact that this story began about 6 months ago, when I was sitting in my office and our secretary called me and said, let us go to the Honorable Minister Dr. Harshvardhan. And he called us and said that Honorable Prime Minister wants that he is already on the smart cities program, but he wants to create a smart coastal village creation, and you should look into that what CSIR can do, and later on follow it to ICAR or other institutions can do. Then after a few months, Secretary MSME invited me to be advisor. I found the same program is there in the MSME that gave me impetus that I should work with the CSIR level to see what could be done to create smart villages across the sea coast. As you see that there is a vast sea coast of 7,500 square kilometers starting from Gulf of Kutch to Rameshwaram and Rameshwaram to Bay of Bengal, and there are 45 million people live over there. So we thought of looking at these areas and see how we can promote the CSIR technologies followed by ICIR technologies in the 66 coastal districts where 45 million persons are living. As we see that then we started studying what should be our initial stress on these coastal areas. First of all, we looked at the local business, because later on we'll see that there are a lot of small tiny things are being developed over there which people are not at all aware of. If you go to every coast, there may be small businesses which there maybe handicrafts are there, maybe toy manufacturing there. So there can be small clusters can be created. Then education is the main area. We can educate the children through the education line as well as technical education. As I go along, I will give you some of the glimpse what we are thinking of. Then health and welfare, because we thought that MSME, as a matter of fact, thinking of starting tertiary healthcare systems over there, and then the democratic engagement, and followed food security. Because I will tell you that about a week back, we had a meeting between the Secretary MSME, Secretary DSIR, we dragged in Secretary DBT, Secretary Food Processing, and Secretary Rural Development to look at this issue that what could be done. All the five ministries can work together in the smart coastal village. Areas. So yesterday Mr. Agarwal was there from Joint Secretary Shipping. I also invited him to join that task force, and I've invited him to meet the Joint Secretary MSME, and they happen to be the good friends. So I am taking him also over there and discussing whether this we can make a paradigm shift on this with the five ministries together and see how the coastal villages could be created. Now, if you look at the what we looked into, there are 13 components to create a smart coastal villages. I will also seek your advice if some 14th or 15th factor can be brought in. The first one is skill development training linked with local resources and economic activities. There, what we feel that every village sector, what we have examined some villages in the Gujarat area, and my friend is missing here. We are working in a big way in the Andhra Pradesh coastal area and Karnataka coastal area. We found that every coastal area has something new or some new patterns are coming, which can we can adopt it as economic activities. Then agro-processing, agri-services, storage and warehousing. This is a very important area we will look into. When I was secretary to Government of India about 10 years back, a file came to me. I know about 60,000 crore, those days 60,000 crore of crops go waste throughout India. Maybe coastal, a portion of that goes in the coastal areas also. So we have now, in the Andhra Pradesh government, we have done an IPR. What we have done from CSIR and Andhra Pradesh government, we have spoken to Container Corporation of India. They have given a liberty to pick up the redundant those containers. We'll bring it up and we will devise cold storage techniques over here, which are pushing as a project to MSME. And also we discussed with Food Processing Ministry. We'll try to find out where a mobile this type of technologies can be developed, container-based technology, low temperature technologies can be developed, so we can move from village to village. And small farmers can put their cottage over there, and stay time will be over 7 days. And we are talking to big business houses like Reliance, Adani's and all, so they can pick it up and then go into retail services so that its wastage is minimized. Also, we have spoken to our CFTRI, the Central Food and Technology Research Institute, as well as Indian Institute of IHBT, Palampur. They have developed a lot of technologies on the food processing. We are talking to Food Processing Ministry whether they can give us some fund to work on this one so that the coastal village people can sell this in the market, as well as the remnant part they can convert into some good products which is sellable. We have a project on called livelihood business model from MSME, where they are giving about 1 crore business loan to the entrepreneurs, or they give about 70 to 80 lakhs of rupees for creating the plant and machineries. That will be housed in one of the technical centers of, because MSME has technical centers in all the states. They are placed over there. The person who is willing to work on that, they can come, they can develop the technology, training can be imparted to them. Then they can lease that on a very, very minimal rent and take it out and then make their own brands. And once the brands are established, SIDBI can give them a soft loan and they can set up their own bases. That is what now 1,000 odd of livelihood mission projects are on, and 1,000 crores are given by Honorable Prime Minister to MSME to start the livelihood business project. So we are thinking at least 30% of that if we bring to the coastal region, and we can, with your help, we can see what are the coastal regions can develop, so we can handhold from the MSME to work on this. Another area is the CFC project, which we call hub and spoke model project, which we are doing a couple of projects in Andhra Pradesh, and larger projects, because 200 crore is being given by Department of Pharmaceuticals, and we are working on that. But this can be possible for creating SPV. If you create a special purpose vehicle with through the association of small entrepreneurs, we can help from the MSME with a model of CFC, the common facility, where common facility can be created, and those 30 to 40 entrepreneurs can be brought in that facility and they can be accommodated, and 20 crore can be given, 5 crore, this will be 75% grant will be given in by the MSME, and 25% we have to generate to SPV, and a nice facility can be created. The next where we're fully equipped mobile health unit and primary healthcare system. This is what we are thinking. We have started, as a matter of fact, a modern village in near Bhubaneswar, which has been totally funded by a professor from MIT. He has come from the University of Chicago. He has taught in MIT, and he has started a modern village. What he has done, he has taken the help of NIRI, our laboratory NIRI, to create sludge treatment, sewage treatment system. And he has also developed a drone, which has been developed by our NSIC laboratory, where the drone he has put for the surveillance of the crop surveillance, etc. Now we are visiting to see what else could be done, and he is going to invest. Now he is investing his own money, coming back to India. But if this can be propagated, that model can propagate to other villages, maybe coastal villages will come up. And we are now thinking of putting tertiary healthcare system also over there. Then upgrading the schools, higher education, skill-based innovation center facilities. We are talking to lot of schools and colleges to come up, because we have a new nice Jigyasa program which is happening in CSIR. We have signed agreement with the Minister of Higher Education, where Jigyasa program is coming. We are trying to see that the central schools can come over there, and in their vacation period, they can teach their school children with the modern tricks and traits. So, then sanitation and treatment plants, that is what we are doing. Sludge treatment plant can be done with the NIRI. We are introducing NIRI to come there and work on that area. Then provision for piped clean drinking water supply. This is one of the very, very major area. And last year, Diwali day, Mr. Nitin Gadkari had given a lecture and TV. And he said waste to wealth is the one of the areas we are looking into. So waste to wealth means that drinking water also comes, because the desalination of water is required, because as you know, the UN Charter says the Indian water level is coming down to over 200 feet. Even where I stay, Gurgaon, it has come to over 300 feet level. There pumping is becoming very difficult. Now, sir, desalination will be the way out. So we are working on that. We have a technology on desalination. We are thinking of working through the solar energy treatment, because we solar panels, and we work into that and see how it can be made viable. So this is one of the areas we're looking into, and I'm very happy to say the state of Andhra Pradesh, state of Karnataka, state of Tamil Nadu, and state of Orissa has given lot of funds to start these projects. And also, as yesterday, Commodore was telling that he had rectified the RO plants in Africa. Similarly, we are also thinking, you may be amused to know that there are 1,500 RO plants lying redundant in the state of Karnataka. So we are now going on a PPP model with a organization called Richardson and Kudas, and we are working with them to see whether the children could be trained and given small equipment can be given, so they need to have run 100 kilometers if their RO plants get out of order. So we can fix that them there, and the money which they get can be good for them for the schooling purpose. Then solid and liquid waste management. This is also one of the areas we're looking into it, and there are a lot of waste is there, as my friend was talking. That in the areas there are lot of your plastics and garbages come on. So we have come out with a beautiful technology from our IIP data dune, where we can convert it into petroleum, and that can convert it into petrol, and then the biochar can be used as a fertilizer. In my next slide, I will show you quickly those things. Then street lights. Street lights is the area where we have made a solar tree. I was just talking to my colleagues before coming, because you may ask how much it costs. So I didn't have the cost, so they told me they have taken a small village of about 50 inhabitants and running of about 30 street lights. That costs about 3 to 4 lakh rupees. They are trying to reduce that cost. But this is called solar tree, and I am very happy to say one solar tree has been presented to Honorable President of India, and one solar tree has gone to the Honorable Prime Minister's house, and we have one solar tree in our CSIR headquarters. So this is one of the areas where we are working into this area. Then inter-village road connectivity. This is also an area where our CRRI, Central Road Research Institute, they have developed a very good technology of plastic laying roads, which we have showcased into the government of Madhya Pradesh. And overnight, we had the minister wanted to come. We had laid our 2 kilometer road and took him and shown. But now new government has come, so we are going to take Kamal Nath for a ride and see how he can see it. And these are very good technologies which have been developed. Now public transport. I am telling you very, very. very important area. This is a very important area because now the electric vehicles are coming, because they drive electric vehicles. Now, if you look at the water of Bay of Bengal, that consists of 0.15% of lithium. This is the only water in the world which have got lithium. Now, businessmen like Warren Buffett are talking to, coming to India and discussing that he wants to put up a lithium ion battery system over there, a extraction plant, lithium ion battery, where our Sikri laboratory, the Central Electrochemical Research Laboratory, who has developed already the technology of lithium ion battery, will be involved. And this is one of the major thrust which from the sea water we will get. Under very, very important issue I want to discuss with you. The Honorable Prime Minister has decided that he has given the task to our Department of Science and Technology, Department of Science and Technology, another department Department of Science and Technology, to build up two deep sea laboratories. One will come in Dwarka and one in Bay of Bengal. He has said 1,000 crores he will give us. That EFC is on, and EFC, if it goes and created by the finance ministry, will Department of Science and Technology create two deep sea laboratories, one in Bay of Bengal and one in Dwarka, because of the fact that he feels that there is a lot of potential from in mining area, in the petrochemicals area, in the front of deep sea. And these two, once the EFC is over, I think this will be granted, because if our Honorable Prime Minister wish, so it will come out. Okay, now I'll quickly go.
Last five minutes.
I'm very poor in. Now, as I told you, these are the laboratories which can work on this, these areas. So I have already explained to you. So you take a note of it. Then there is one area which is very important, is the from that we have developed a double fortified salt which has gone through clinical trial, and we will get a better iodized salt which is being promoted for the health purpose. Then I was telling you that regarding the product from that biomass, biochar, bio-oil, this is our IAPA developed, which I explained already. This is actually a product from the husks which are generated in the sea coast. This can be used, well utilized. This is another area. This is a seaweed. Seaweed is a area which needs to be developed properly, because India is right now producing about 1% of global consumption. And to your information, that the countries like Indonesia and Malaysia are developed. They are capturing 60% of the market. And yesterday I was told that there are so many small islands over there, and it develops quite well in the island. So there are our 1,400 islands over there. We can take that into consideration, see whether seaweed can be grown over there. And as a matter of fact, we have created a committee under the chairmanship of Mr. Rajiv Kumar in Niti Aayog, and we're looking into this. And we have made a white paper through Department of Science and Technology, and we're looking into this. And we are promoting this in a better way, because India can grow this in a better fashion. And this is, so many islands are there, we can go into and work in this fashion. This is also a sea-based technology. I am very poor on it, I am telling you. Now, No, well, I'll skip this because time is... Now, water desalination, we have... Water desalination, there are three types of technologies we have got. Membrane mobile... Membranes module and plant-based technologies, which we have. So we have got all the three technologies. And as a matter of fact, I am very happy to say that Minister of Defense and Navy has contacted us because all the new upcoming ships, they want to put up RO technology with solar maneuvered RO technologies, which we are looking into it and we are discussing with the Minister of Defense to work on it, and maybe we'll come down to the to other ships also. And this is a very good technology which we have developed. Similarly, I will not show the slides, but I will tell you, we are coming in a big way in the housing technology, because housing also is one of the areas where we want to work very fast, because of the fact that our laboratory like CBRI IHBT, even we have developed a bamboo-based structure, which is a termite and water resistant. So we are looking at this will be very, very beneficial for the village and coastal village and village areas, because of the fact that this costs very less. And also we are trying to do some sort of a energy efficient system like we are working on some sort of a Swiss system with NIRI and a coastal water reunification with NIRI. I have been able to give you I'm very sorry, but I'm very poor in this thing. But the thing is, I tried to give a glimpse of it, but time is short, so I'm giving a glimpse of it. You want to ask any question, I will be ready to answer.